Welcome back to AM to DM. I'm Amadal Yakber, host of the podcast See Something, Say Something here at BuzzFeed News. And I'm here with Solmaz Sharif, president of the New York Persian Cultural Center, to talk about Nowruz, which is also sometimes called Persian New Year. Nowruz Mubarak.
Thank you. It's Spring Mubarak.
we put together our best version of a hafseen. I don't know if we did a good job or not.
Can you
tell us what is a hafseen and what are these items in front of us?
Sure, absolutely. Nowruz is the spring equinox and celebrates in different countries in that region. For Iranian or for Persians are 7 items, each symbolize something. We
right.
also have 7 fruits. Half maybe. So this one, it's fruit of dried fruit,
Senjet,
represents love. Sumak, it's represents color of sunrise. Apple represents beauty and health. Vinegar represents medicine. Garlic also represents health. Oh no, vinegar represents
patience.
And garlic represents medicine. And then we have sprout that represents rebirth and a flower.
So, and there's a lot of different items that can make it up, but these are just some of the ones that can make up a hafseen. They can be really big, right?
Yeah, so there are like items such as mirror that represents self-reflection and candle represents light. So there are other items that don't start with S
right.
that you put them, and but there are also like backup items
right.
like coin represent wealth. And, you know, obviously
of course,
that
gotta represent wealth.
Exactly. So that those things are added later on comparing
so
to the original.
We have one other special Nowruz item, which is the goldfish.
Yes.
Can't be spring equinox until we have these goldfish to celebrate spring. So we'll bring those out at the end of the segment.
Cool.
So it does seem like there is a little bit of arguments about what Nowruz really is. You know, Twitter posted on their Twitter faith page that they made this special emoji for Nowruz, and you know, it's the Persian New Year. They, I think, used the sabzi, the greens, as the little emoji that they put next to Nowruz. And the comment section was really interesting to me because people were saying, you know, it's not a religious holiday and it's not a it's not just a Persian holiday. So what really is Nowruz?
So first of all, I must say it's such a cool thing when at Cultural, at NYPC, New York Persian Center, we try to basically add this celebration to people's lives. So any action toward it is welcome. And I think we shouldn't be that tight about that. So it's nice that Twitter is doing that.
Right.
But Nowruz originally started as a Zoroastrian holiday.
Right, right.
And at the time of Persian Empire. So now it's only in Iran and Afghanistan that is celebrated as a new year, but there are tons of countries that they celebrate it, like all Kurds in all 4 countries, Azerbaijan, Tajikistan,
right.
Tajik part of Pakistan. The list goes on, and it's celebrated by UNESCO. So originally was faith, now it's not anymore, because, you know, there are these countries that have different official religion, but everyone is so rooted into this holiday and celebrated so dearly.
It seems like the identity around Persianness is quite strong, and sometimes the conversation is centered around Iranians, but looking at your the work you guys do at the Persian Cultural Center, I was so impressed with the diversity of people who celebrate Nowruz. Also, one of my favorite Iranian celebrities in America is Yara Shahidi. She's the star of Grownish, and she posted this amazing selfie of her and her beautiful family, who you should all follow on Instagram. They're amazing. What is it like to see like a young celebrity like that so proud in their Iranian heritage?
Yara is our favorite too. And her hafseen table was very cool. Yes, for different reasons, mainly for political reasons, Iranians try to identify with Persian after revolution in America, understandably. But the Persian for us, it's more diverse. It's all the Persian ethnicity, so Iran, Afghanistan, Tajikistan, and the minorities we have. They are from different ethnicity, like Azeris, Kurds.
And but religious minorities as well, right? Right?
Yes.
It's all the different religions in, for instance, Iran celebrate Nowruz, correct?
Exactly. So that's why people say it's not a religious holiday. day.
Right.
You know, Muslims, Christians, Jews, everyone in Iran, they celebrate Nowruz. It's a national holiday. But again, it's really bigger than that. Plus, it's, you know, celebrating a spring.
Right.
Do I need a reason for that?
Right. It's like our Groundhog's Day, sort of. Exactly. That's what we do, right, in America. The other thing that you mentioned to me was that you are having some issues with Venmo around and some of the online paying services around some of the work you're doing. Can you tell me about that?
Sure. It's not only Venmo. It's Venmo, PayPal, and Google. So far, we had problem with it. We are super proud to start the first ever Persian magazine of New York. It's bilingual, English and Persian, and it's called Persian Life. So this is the first issue. The next issue comes in April. So obviously we started, you know, putting it for sale and for like just buying one or have a annual subscription.
Right.
And if people are paying it through Venmo and app and PayPal, and they don't mention Persian, comes like that.
The
transaction approves. If they mention Persian Life subscription, goes for review for 48 hours. I mean, comes
basically late. The money doesn't go through, right?
Mostly comes through. One time, name was very different.
I know there was a story where Venmo flagged the name Ahmed, which is my name, by the way, and asked the user to explain the reference to Ahmed. Who is Ahmed? But it was just like a payment. So
this one, yes, exactly. Both first name and last name was very Muslimy, so they completely rejected. So far, we had, like, after review, they approved the transaction, but this one, they returned the money. And the other thing is we've been advertising our center and classes, activities we have on Google Ad, no problem. We try to have a campaign to advertise this magazine. The entire Google Ad account was suspended.
Right.
So
considering what we talked about the cultural identity, it's so interesting and kind of disturbing how that is being sort of, in a way, made to feel criminalized a little bit, you know, that it might be used for unsavory things, you know.
I must say we are very disheartened because it's a, I ask Venmo, they reference to OFAC, which OFAC is sending money to Iran, but Persian, we're talking about ethnicity, three countries, languages, all of that. So as a New York-based business, we're trying to figure this out.
So hope you resolve that. But before we go, we have to bring out the goldfish. Bring them out.
Yay!
So I know that I've heard that in some families that it's not the Persian New Year until they look at each other. Have you heard of this tradition?
I haven't. And this is my first time doing it. But I like it.
Let's see if we can have them look at each other.
Goldfishy!
Okay, let's see. Is it working?
It's cheat.
Okay, they're looking. Their eyes are sideways. There we go. All right. Thank you so much, Salman.
Sure, absolutely. Thank you.
And Nowruz Mubarak. If you'd like to hear more about Nowruz, See Something, Say Something has a whole episode about Nowruz coming out this Friday. Up next, Stephanie will be talking to women running for office in 2018.